Okay, so in today's video, we're going to take a look at finding terms in a linear sequence. So for this first question, we've been given the nth term of a sequence to be 4n plus 3. So for this first part of the question, we need to find the first two terms of the sequence. So we're looking for term number 1 and term number 2. So when we've got an expression for the nth term, and we want to find a specific term number, all we have to do is substitute that term number in for n. So to find that first term number, all we're going to do is substitute in n equals 1. So we're going to take our expression, 4n plus 3, and I'm just going to substitute that n for 1. So we're going to have 4 times 1, then plus 3. So then to simplify, we'd do 4 multiplied by 1, which is 4, which we then add on the 3, and that would give us 7. So that would be our first term in the sequence. To then find our second term in the sequence, we're looking for term number 2. So here n would be equal to 2. So then again, all we do is substitute into the nth term. So we'd have 4 multiplied by 2, then add 3. So simplifying, 4 times 2 gives us 8. Add on the 3, that would give us 11. So the second term in the sequence is 11. So that's how we can use the nth term. The n is actually the term number that we can substitute in to actually find that particular term in the sequence. So our term number that we substitute in, or our value for n, will always be an integer or a whole number. So for this second part of the question, it asks us if 35 is a term in the sequence. So the way we do this is we try and look for the term number. We want to find out what the value of n is if that 35 would be in the sequence. So we want to set up an equation. We know the nth term of the sequence is 4n plus 3. And we want to know if 35 is in this sequence. So we want to know if this is equal to 35. So we want to solve this now. But remember what we said earlier. Our value for n, if it's in the sequence, must be an integer. It must be a whole number for it to be in the sequence. So if we solve this equation now and we get an integer for n, we know that that term 35 is actually in the sequence. However, if it turns out not to be an integer, we know then it isn't in the sequence. So we've got a two-step equation now. We've got 4n plus 3 is equal to 35. So to begin with, I'm going to get rid of this 3. I've got plus 3 on the left. So to get rid of it, I'm going to do the opposite. So I'm going to take away 3 on this side. But then to keep things equivalent, I'm also going to do that on the right-hand side. So on the left-hand side now, we've got that 3, take away 3, so they've cancelled. So we're just left with 4n on the left-hand side. And then on the right, we've got 35, take away 3, which gives us 32. So we now know that 4n is equal to 32. So now we're solving for n, so we've got 4 times n. So I'm going to do the opposite, so I'm going to divide the left-hand side by 4, which means I've got to do exactly the same to the right-hand side. So if we do 4n divided by 4, that's just going to give us n. And then on the right-hand side, we'd have 32 divided by 4, well, that gives us 8. So now we've got n is equal to 8. So because we've got an integer, we know that it is in the sequence. 35 would actually be term number 8 in this sequence. So when it says, is 35 a term in the sequence, we can simply say yes. Because n is an integer. So therefore, we know it's in the sequence. Okay, let's try this method with another question. Okay, for this one, we've been given that the nth term of a sequence is 7n take away 5. We want to find the 6th and the 11th term of this particular sequence. So we know when we're looking for particular term numbers, the term numbers are the numbers that we're going to substitute for n. So for the 6th term of the sequence, we're just going to substitute in n is equal to 6. So then substituting into our expression, we'd have 7, and instead of n, we have our 6. I'm just going to put that there in a bracket, then minus 5. So we'd have 7 multiplied by 6, which is 42, which then we need to take away 5. So that would give us 37. So that 37 would be the sixth term in the sequence. We're then looking for the 11th term. So now we want to substitute n is equal to 11. So we'd have 7 multiplied by 11, which then we're going to take away 5 from. So 7 multiplied by 11 gives us 77. We're then taking away 5. Well, that's going to leave us with 72. So the 11th term of this sequence is just 72. We then want to see if 22 is a term in the sequence. So going off the question we've just done, whenever we want to see if a term is in the sequence, we're just going to put it equal to the nth term, and we should get an integer for our variable n. If we don't, then we know it's not in the sequence. So we're going to start with 7n, take away 5, and we're going to put it equal to 22. We've then got a two-step equation that we need to solve. So I'm going to get rid of that take away 5 first. So instead of minus 5, what I can do to get rid of that is I can add 5 to this side, but then I've also got to do the same to the right-hand side. So I'm going to add 5 there as well. So if I add 5 to the left-hand side, I'm just going to be left with 7n. And then on the right-hand side, we've got 22 plus 5, which is going to give us 27. So now we've got 7n. So 7 multiplied by n, we want to do the opposite of that. So I'm going to divide this side by 7. And then I've also got to do that on the right-hand side as well. So 7n divided by 7 is just going to give us n. And we've now got 27 divided by 7. So I'm just going to write that as a fraction to begin with. We've now got 27 over 7. Well, we know 27 isn't in the 7 times table, so we're not going to end up with an integer now. We're going to end up with a decimal. If we actually did put this in the calculator, we'd end up with 3.857142, with these digits repeating between 8 and 2. So we know because our value of n isn't an integer, then 22 isn't going to be a term in the sequence. This would actually fall somewhere between term number 3 and term number 4. So when it asks us again if this is a term in the sequence, we can simply say no. And then just like before, because n is not an integer. So we can actually check this because we said because it's 3.8 something, we know it's going to fall between term number 3 and term number 4. So if we found term number 3, that would just be 7 multiplied by 3, take away the 5. So we'd have 21 take away 5, which is 16. And then term number 4, we'd have 7 multiplied by 4, take away 5. So that would be 28 take away 5, which gives us 23. So we can see that that term 22 would actually fall between these two here. Okay, and for this final question, we're given that the first four terms of a sequence are 16, 12, 8, and 4. For the first part of this question, we want to find the nth term of the sequence. So to begin with, all I'm going to do here is label my four terms. We have term number 1, term number 2, term number 3, and term number 4. So the first thing we're going to do is find the difference between each term. What's happening from term to term? Well, to get from 16 to 12, we're taking away 4. Then from 12 to 8, we're taking away 4 again. And then finally from 8 to 4, we're taking away 4 again. So because we've got a common difference from term to term, we know we've got a linear sequence. So we're now looking for the nth term. So we're going to have n. And then the coefficient or the number in front of n is just going to be the difference that we found between the terms. So because we're taking away 4 each time, we're going to have negative 4 in front of the n. We then need to finish off our expression for the nth term. So the way we find the bit that comes on the end of this expression is by finding our term number 0. So to find term 0, we're going to follow the same rule that we did with all the other terms from term to term. We were taking away 4. So the same must have applied here. So something take away 4, give us 16. Well, we can just do the opposite of this. So 16, add on the 4, that would actually give us 20. So the term that come before 16 would actually be 20. So this is what's going to come at the end of our expression. Because it's positive, we're simply going to put plus 20. So the nth term for this particular sequence would just be negative 4n plus 20. Okay, and for this last question, we want to find the 15th term of this particular sequence. So because we're looking for term number 15, that's the number we're going to substitute for our value of n. So we're going to use our expression negative 4n plus 20, and we're just going to substitute that 15 for the n. So I'm going to put it there in a bracket, and then we can simplify. So we've got negative 4 multiplied by 15. Well, that's going to give us negative 60, but then we need to add 20. So if we do negative 60, add on the 20, that's going to leave us with negative 40. So we know when this sequence continues, we're going to eventually get to term number 15. So when we get to term 15, we know that the term in the sequence here would be negative 40. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on working with the nth term, then I've left some links for them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.